Like to call a roll?
Call a roll. Hetzke?
Here.
Bastion?
Here.
Denoncourt?
Here.
Knauer?
Here.
McCord? Tidings?
Here.
Nursinger? I'm here. Sangster?
Here.
Weisser? Nope. O'Connor?
Yes.
Valentine?
Nope. All right.
Here we go.
We have minutes.
Yes, minutes were provided from the work session in June from the 25th. If there aren't any issues, concerns, errors that anyone saw, we can entertain a vote.
I'll vote to approve.
Well, that was Jinx City.
I'll second.
Okay, well, Knauer and Bastion. Call the roll.
All right, Hetzke.
Aye.
Bastion.
Aye.
Noncourt.
Aye.
Knauer.
Aye.
Tidings?
Aye.
Thank you. And we have one tabled item from our previous, many previous meetings for 2775 Penfield Road. We've been taking no action on it, and there have since been no updates to this point. However, I did meet the gentleman today, Mr. Romeo, at the counter. I am expecting updates for our August meeting.
Okay.
But until then, we can continue to take no action if everyone's okay with that.
Yeah, we're okay with that.
Okay.
All right, any miscellaneous items?
Those were my two items for the work session portion of the meeting right now. And nothing else miscellaneous to present.
All right, anybody have any other business? Should we adjourn or go into recess or recess until 7 o'clock for the public hearing?
Let's do that.
And welcome to the July 9th, 2015 meeting of the Penfield Planning Board. As usual, we will begin the meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everybody, for coming. We have three items on our agenda tonight. We have a sketch plan, which is a kind of a not really casual look, but a first look at a potential project. So it's not an official application. It's informal, I guess is the word that I was looking for, an informal review of a concept idea that somebody has. And so they'll present it. So not a lot of detail might be in it. It's more conceptual, generally speaking. And so then we'll review it. We'll ask some questions. We'll open up to the audience. And then we finish up afterwards. We'll issue a letter with our comments over the next week or something like that. The two items after that are subdivision and site plan approval, and those are public hearings. So same kind of process that we have. The applicant will present their project. The board will ask questions, and we open it up for the audience to we welcome your comments. So that's a big reason why we're here, is that we want to hear what the public has to say. So with that, Zach, if you could read the first item.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Sketch plan application number one, Parrone Engineering, 349 West Commercial Street, Suite 3200 East Rochester, New York, 14445. On behalf of Kevin Farrell, requests an informal discussion with the board regarding plans to construct a one-story, 10,150 square foot storage building and a one-story, 1,600 square foot office building with associated site improvements on a total of 3.14 acres located at 1677 Penfield Road and 10 Plaza, the description here says Drive, that was a typo, it's Plaza Circle, Rochester, New York, 14625. The properties are now or formerly owned by Raymond Pizzillo and Lynn Perry Properties, LLC, and are zoned LB and GB. Application number 15P-0015, SBL numbers
138.08-1-31 and 138.08-1-42.4.
All right,
Kevin.
Okay. Hi, everybody.
This is...
Can you introduce yourself and give us your address just for the record?
My home address?
Well, or your work address.
My work address is the Penfield Storage, which is located behind the Home Depot and in Penfield.
You're Kevin Farrell.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So we're looking at, there's two things, as Zach had mentioned, that we're looking at doing right now for expansion. The general idea here for me is to get some road frontage. We are currently behind the Home Depot, behind Charlie Brown's, and an office building in the front. We don't have any exposure to Penfield Road, which we believe is going to help the business significantly. It's a little tough right now not having drive-by or walk-in business. And so our plan is to, it's two phases. One is to access through this property right now, which we have under contract. It's a 250 foot by about, averages about 70 foot wide parcel, which is just to the east of Charlie Brown's restaurant in between Penwood Apartments. The idea there is we would put our office up front and gain access to drive-by traffic and get a sign out front, and we would be taking down the two existing buildings that are on the property now in order to do so. The second part is the construction of a climate control building in the back here, which would run essentially north and south. And that building is actually set for to be about 290 feet. We initially were hoping for 340, but there's a sanitary easement on the south side of the property that really requires us to shorten the length of the building. So it's currently at 35 by 290 is how it's set up.
Okay. So you're looking to potentially do this in two phases, is that?
We would do it in one phase. There's a couple things we need to work out engineering wise, but we would do the construction in one phase. It's just two different pieces because we would be combining the parcels here and then construction.
So subdivision, combining the two parcels into one.
Yes.
And then raising the two structures on the current buildings that are
correct
east of Charlie Brown's.
Yes.
And then building a new retail single story.
Yep, single story office. There'd be the front part, there'd be four parking spots is what right now we're looking to get in front. We really don't need much more than that in storage. So between the building and the road, there would be four spots. And there's additional land behind that. I've talked to my neighbor, Ron at Charlie Brown's, about allowing him some additional parking in there as well. So he gets pretty tight sometimes on holidays and things like that. So we're trying to keep, to keep the setbacks reasonable and also to help our neighbor there as well. And I've talked to him a little bit about how we would do that and going to get some more input from him as far as the landscaping and setup and how we would set up parking and things like that.
There's a fence there right now, isn't there?
Right now between Charlie Brown's and this parcel here, that there isn't. It's paved in the back with no, there's nothing in between. There used to be a small one there, and then there's a hedge on about half of it. And the back part's open. You could drive in and loop all the way around the restaurant. And the idea was to keep it there. The gate would be, the access gate would be back in this area, so his employees would be able to park over our property would be closed at their busiest time, so he could slide 4 to 6 cars over behind us without having to access the property.
Okay. This retail building in the plan, it says 80 by 20, so about 1,600 square feet.
Yeah, we were actually hoping to do it a little bit longer, just the way we found an office building out in Buffalo that we really wanted to to copy exactly. It's 20 feet wide. It's in a very similar parcel. And we saw how they had it set up with their maintenance people and where they, you know, they kept a golf cart for the to run around the property and clean out units and things like that. So we had it, our last one that we did with Perone's was 20 by 110 was the total.
So this would all be yours? You wouldn't rent out part of it to another tenant?
No. Or? No, it would, you know, just be for the Penfield storage. And the other thing that I think would be nice if this goes through is to we have access right now out. There's one way in and out. This would provide another way, which, you know, we had talked that over with the folks as far as the fire goes, getting access in and out. They kind of like the idea of having two ways in, and we would be fencing the whole property, which also helps. We do lose some business on people that they see it's not gated. They don't like that as well. So that would be something we do, fence the entire thing in, which would help for security and
all the way down to Plaza Circle, or
we'd cut it right. The fence would be right kind of at the end here. We wouldn't go all the way down to the Home Depot parking lot. There just wouldn't make any sense. So we're going to cut it right over and then run it east west right here.
Okay. The proposed architecture that you have in mind for the storage building and the office.
Yep.
Could you maybe elaborate on that, what your ideas are right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, so the building, as far as the storage building goes, the climate control ones are all interior. So from the outside, they don't have any doors. The lights, we already keep the lights off to the east for courtesy to Penwood Apartments. So there would only be lighting on this side. So they wouldn't be able to see, the apartments wouldn't be able to see any lighting, and there would be motion. So they would only come on if somebody was on the property, and that they would be set up. I think we had 8 total this way to keep it lit. And then that's just a heated, cooled building, kept around 60 degrees in the winter, and right around 70, 68, 70 in the summer. Inside the building, I think we had a total of 88 or 86 units. They range anywhere from the little open door, you know, 5x5s to 10x20s inside there. So
can you go into a little bit about what kind of traffic flow you get today, you know, maybe per hour? Are there peaks?
Maybe give us
an idea of what kind of traffic you see, and then what it might be after, you know, with this potential build out.
We actually would have hour right now. We have 24 without having a gate. People can access it anytime. We would set up hours where gate access would be a little more limited at night. And again, it depends on the weather. You get a snowstorm and there won't be a tire track on the place at the end of the day. But then if it's a nice day, or this is a busy season and people are moving in and out, I'd say there's probably maybe 2 people on the property maximum in the busy time. And once in a while, maybe 3, but that's about it. So it's pretty low impact when it comes to that. There wouldn't be any additional doors going up and down or making any noise earlier. These are all be inside. And of course, the front building would just be office. That's just 9 to 6, 6 days a week. So it is pretty low impact as far as that goes.
And you own more storage facilities around?
Some, yeah. Yeah, I manage some other ones, and this is the one right now that we're trying to get. It's been tough competition-wise because there's a lot of these popping up all over, and you know, we've been there for 35 years or 30 years now, so it's difficult to compete. So we've seen that climate control really helps, increases the value. People are asking for it more and more. Pharmaceutical reps need to have their products at a certain temperature now, so there's more regulations and more people are asking for it. Antique people. Even wine storage, things like that. So it's we're seeing quite a bit of that.
Okay.
Kevin, I just got a couple questions about what about all the vehicles on site there when I was by there last couple?
Yeah, I was warned about that a couple weeks ago. I've had outdoor storage with my landscapers with containers, and we have the Home Depot side is clear except for one trailer. And I have 3 more campers that are out here that I've notified the people, and I'm just going to move them by the end of a week from tomorrow, if they're not there, I notified everybody. There was five total. So we're down to three and two trucks, and the truck guy's going to be out in the middle of next week. So.
Do they actually operate businesses out of there?
Yeah, they do.
The landscaping and the
landscapers, yeah, they keep their trailers in there, yeah, and it's they'll leave their truck that they drive normally, will park there in the morning, or a car, and they'll meet a couple workers and then take off to a job. So, but I already told them this is not the use here, and that was made pretty clear by the town. So, again, by next Friday, come on down, it'll be clean. It was it took a little while for a couple people to respond because they weren't local. That's the only reason anything's left there now.
And so if you go ahead with this project the way it is right now, how many variances do you think you're going to need for it?
The setback variances, no use variance, just the setback variances.
With Pembroke?
Yes.
Apartments?
Yep.
Yeah, because, I mean, it's pretty close right now.
Right.
When I was out there, I mean, you can see the apartments right to the... Now, who's the buffering along there? Who owns all that buffering right now? Is it yours or theirs?
Yeah, it's mine. The berm and all the trees and stuff along the edges is mine.
Yeah. And what are you going to ask for the variance? How close are you going to put it?
15.
15.
15 from the outside. Yeah.
So that buffers stay.
It there's a couple of trees that would have to go. Or at least get trimmed back. But we went along and looked at the ones we could keep, and everything that right now you can't see through it at all. And there's a lot of pines there as well. But yeah, two trees out of 100 yards would be the only two that have to go. Pretty small ones. They've just kind of grown up, and we're probably going to take those two out.
What's your occupancy rate right now over there?
Right now, about 88.
And you're usually there during the daytime?
Yep.
That's it for me.
Yeah, I had a few questions, Kevin. The two existing structures that you're taking down, what's the square footage of those two?
I don't know. I'm not sure. I have it in my car, but I can get back to you on that one. The building in the back is a single story, and I think that one's it's around 20 by 42 or 44, right in that area. There's a block building in the back that's just a single story. Mm-hmm. I don't know what it is in the front one.
Okay.
There's a total of three apartments there, two in the front, one in the back.
For the controlled climate storage, the HVAC units, where would those be located?
Those would be on the end, on here and here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So those would be at ground level?
Yes.
Okay. And for that facility, is there any plans for a backup generator or anything to maintain?
No.
Okay.
The ones that we've done before, we've never had backup generators on them. That's something that, depending on if they get to the two-story, they recommend that you have the backup. But they say that these one-story ones hold the heat or cool quite well. So they, at least that wasn't in the specs from the Buffalo guy that built it. We're copying the ones that we've already done with this company's already done a few for us in the past, and they've, I'll have the exact details and the outside pictures of the one as well.
Okay, thank you.
I had a question. For the HVAC units that you just said were on the ends,
yep.
They're near the apartment side, right?
They're actually in the front of the building on this side, and there's like a little alcove that they have set up, so there's three entrances, and they're to the right of the entrance as you walk in, so they're actually facing toward the west corners here in.
So they would be in an enclosed area, or
yes,
partially enclosed?
Three-way enclosed. Yep.
Okay.
Any other
I just have one question.
Yep.
You said you would need setback variance. What about green space?
We're going to pick up, depending on the final, how the front gets finalized, we're going to pick up some more up here. This is all paved now, all the way front and back. And we wouldn't need any of this to be paved, depending on how many parking spots we're required to put in. I'd like to do four here, and if we did 4 to 6 in the back, we would lose about 6% of our green space.
What do you have now for green space?
I don't know what the number is now.
Okay.
But I can, Perone's got that. They calculated it out, and I'll get that back to you.
I do have another question. What about snow storage?
So right now what we do is we do this run, and they plow straight up to the fence here, to the Home Depot fence. So we generally plow it out this way because this has always had our trailers and containers. Mm-hmm. We've never used this except for the front corner for snow. And so the idea was that we would put a snow gate up to the front, and they'd be able to knock it back in this corner here, which we don't do now because there's a sewer clean out there for Charlie Brown's, which will have to be moved. But if we can drive over it and plow to that corner, it should be the same way. We went over that with a guy that does it now.
Okay, thanks.
Yep.
One more question.
Sure.
If would you be able to go forward with it if you just get the approval for tearing down the front two houses so you can get your driveway in there and your signage? Yeah.
Probably not, just cost-wise, because it's, you know, we can't do any storage up here, so this is just to gain access. The way the bank has it set up, and the numbers really only work if we can do an addition on in the back. It's just the only way. And we also would do, part of that would improve the paving, because this needs paving on the front, the sides as well, so we need them both.
Any other questions from the board?
Mm-hmm. Okay, would anyone in the audience like to comment on this sketch plan? No? Okay. Mr. Farrell, nice job. Thank you for your time.
Thanks.
Do you have any final
No, but I'll get the questions that I didn't have answers to. I'll make sure I get back to each respectively gentleman. So sorry I didn't have them handy. Okay.
It's all right. Yep. It's a sketch plan.
Okay.
It's what it's for. Yeah. So thank you for coming.
Thanks.
And we will we'll get a letter out to you.
Okay. Super. Appreciate it.
All right, Zach. Item number two, please.
All right, item number two. Ed Summerhays, 2509 Browncroft Boulevard, Suite 209, Rochester, New York, 14625, on behalf of David Schoff, requests under Article 8-8-3 of the Code for Preliminary Final Subdivision Approval to resubdivide the 47.55 acre parcel at 1450 Marchner Road, Webster, New York, 14580, and the 2.13 acre parcel located at 1394 Marchner Road, Webster, New York. And again, here's a correction from the legal statement. Should read 14580 from 2 to 3 parcels. The properties are now or formerly owned by David Schoff and Elaine Schoff and Roy Green and Meredith O'Brien Green, and are zoned RA2. Application number 15P-0013, SBL numbers 095.01-1-63.3 and 095.01-1-63.103. Go ahead, Ed.
Thank you very much. I'm here on behalf of my clients who are also sitting in the audience. If any questions come up that I can't answer, hopefully they'll be here and can answer those questions. But as you've put it, Mr. Schoff has about 47 and a half acres of land, and Mr. Green has about 2, and what I'm doing mentally here is to combine them together. Ultimately, Mr. Green is buying 10 acres from Mr. Schoff, and we're adding that to his 2-acre parcel, so that Mr. Green's going to end up with 12.1 acres of land. And the reason I'm here is that it's not an administrative subdivision. We're also pulling out a 9.5 acre parcel that he is going to sell to others, and you'll be hearing that application tonight for a proposed residence on that parcel. So that's the middle lot two, and that's going to be about 9 acres in size. And then the remaining lands, is 27.9 acres. and that will remain with Mr. Green. And I just might want to point out at this particular time, because it was never in our discussions, you'll notice that the strip on the north end of Lot 2 is a 60-foot wide strip that gives Mr. Schoff access to the parcel to the west of that. Ultimately, down the road, and we don't know how far down the road, but we did that specifically so that eventually Mr. Green would buy that remaining lands to the north. We could add that to his parcel, and that 60-foot strip would be added to the 9.5-acre parcel, making that a 10-acre parcel when all is said and done, and then the remaining lands would again stay. So it really has nothing to do with this application, but that's what we're thinking down the road, and that's why it has that unusual configuration that we have now. Since our application, we have received comments from the Monroe County Planning Council, which many of their comments are environmental in nature, but this is because this is this particular application, we're not proposing any improvements. Those really don't affect the comments regarding engineering do not affect this, or the environment do not affect this parcel. And then the usual boilerplate, this map will be filed in the clerk's office, and when we get to that point, the Monroe County surveyor will check to make to verify that there are no geodetic monuments in the area, and it's not. From the count from the town, I have received the one comment and request for a 30-foot drainage easement over over the creek and its tributaries, and I've asked Mr. Schoff if that was acceptable to him, and it is. So we have no problem creating the descriptions and a map that can be filed in the clerk's office, granting the town the drainage easement and access to those to that. And with that, I'm probably the shortest presentation I've ever made here.
Just a couple questions. I know there's no plan as of right now for anything to be built. That'll be a future application.
Yes.
But are any driveways going to go in at this time, or any access roads into the land?
No. No, that will most likely be addressed on the following, on the application
future.
Following this one. So on my plan, no.
Okay.
Or for my application, no.
So as of right now, no change will be taken other than just on paper?
That's correct.
No changes to the property?
That's correct.
Okay. Existing structures. For any of this area, is any of this a wetland area?
Actually, yes. There's quite a bit of area around the creek and its tributaries that is within the floodplain, and some of that is wetland. And again, because we're not doing any improvements on our side of the mm-hmm. application, I haven't shown that. And again, I think that will most likely come up on the next application.
Okay. Any other questions?
All right, thanks.
Sure. Yeah, Ed, just one question. Is it still a working, what is it, the Christmas tree farm or something? Did I see a sign there? It's too.
I don't believe, now that's one that I might have trouble answering, but I don't think he's doing Christmas trees anymore.
No.
No.
Not at this time, no.
Woodworking? It was
woodcrafting, yes.
Okay. Okay, it was out there.
Okay. Today. So for those that can't hear, that was the no to the Christmas trees, yes to woodworking.
Thank you.
All the folks at home.
For all the folks home.
I just want to, right now, if I'm looking at the plan, lot 1, 2, and 3 are all one lot, correct?
all right, I'm going to step away
sort
from.
Except for lot 2 or lot 3, is that dashed line?
I'm going to highlight that on my map if you'll.
Okay.
That highlighted line right there is the north line of Mr. Green's property right now. So all that.
And he wants to buy the flag, if you will, or the L-shaped section to the north.
Yeah, let me, I'll step away from the mic. This whole area is all part of Mr. Schoff's property. So right. The only thing that Mr. Green owns at this time is that one little 2-acre parcel.
Right there.
Right there.
Right.
And maybe I was confusing the way I introduced it when I said, in my mind, I kind of put it all together and then separated it.
Well, but, you know, you look at the plan, you say, oh, yeah, okay, and then, well, wait a sec. So
yeah.
I appreciate the clarity. So.
Yeah.
So lot 3 would then would be that
unusual
L, say.
Yes.
And lot 1 is an odd-shaped flag lot, and the future plan for that, you said, was for lot 2 to potentially take over the northwest portion of lot 1 and the small strip to
yeah.
the north?
This is in concept now. I'm going to add some more
right,
lines
and I understand
to the map
that
here.
That's not part of this, but
right. It would, so it ultimately could end up.
Okay, so then what would happen to the square parcel? Yeah. That becomes part of lot 3?
Yes. No. Yes. Yes. Lot 3.
Okay.
And that's a dream at this time.
Right.
So we're hoping, but we wanted to make sure we had access to that. We certainly did not want to create a landlocked parcel. But
that was where I was going.
But that is the ultimate goal down the road. And at this time, I'm not going to even try to make a prediction on that.
Okay. I'm good. Anybody else?
No.
Bill?
No.
Anybody in the audience like to comment on this application? Going once?
I don't want to speak for them, but I think they're all in favor.
All right. Never know. All right. Ed, thank you. If nobody else has any comments, do you have any?
All right. No, I have.
Shots
I have.
That you need to take at us.
No, I've got my shots in. I appreciate it. Thanks very much. It's always a pleasure.
All right. Thank you.
And you don't need this map up here.
I think we'll.
Step 2.
And our final application for this evening. BME Associates, 10 Liftbridge Lane East, Fairport, New York. 14450 on behalf of Steve McAlpin, hope I said that right, requests under Articles 3-3-10 and 9-9-2 of the Code for Preliminary and Final Site Plan and EPOD permit approval to construct a single-family residential home on 9.6 acres of the property located at 1450 Marchner Road, Webster, New York, 14580. The property is now formerly owned by David Schoff and Elaine Schoff and is zoned RA2. Application number 15P-0014, SBL number 095.01-1-63.3.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Fred Shelley from BME Associates, representing Mr. McAlpin, who's in the audience tonight. In his request for preliminary and final site plan approval for the construction of a single-family home on Lot 2 of the Schoff Green subdivision. The site is planned to be accessed by an existing road driveway that is leading onto the site, and then the site driveway will branch off where the property line diverges, the driveway diverges from the property line, and then that will come up to the house. The home will be served by public water via private water service, and it'll also be served by a on-site wastewater treatment system designed by Monroe County Specs, Health Department Specs.
So the driveway would be a shared driveway?
No, it's an existing driveway where it is, and actually the drive, sorry.
There's a microphone right in front of you, so I think
this one.
We're technically, technologically advanced here at Penfield. Where
there we go. Yes, the current driveway does come up and it goes into the land that will be acquired by, I believe, Mr. Green. But that portion of the driveway will be abandoned and it won't be shared. The back portion of the property will be accessed from Mr. Green's property, I believe.
Got it. Sorry.
Does any portion of the house, does it encroach on the buffers for the wetlands?
No, it doesn't. That's a good question. Let me switch to another map that we have.
Okay.
We prepared a total holding sketch on the grading plan, which shows the proposed, actually the furthest building that we're proposing is a detached structure, accessory structure, and the plan shows that we're about 310 feet from the closest environmental protection overlay district or, okay. or wetlands.
Now you're, if I read right, you're 590 feet from the right-of-way on the Marchner Road?
That's correct.
It would take 10 feet. Any plans for a sprinkler system or?
The plans for the sprinkler system is to comply with number one, the New York State Building Code, and also the town's code without any specific waivers requested.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's all I have, AJ.
Okay. Any other questions from the board?
I had one question. You show another. Garage further back on the lot. Is that just for storage of personal vehicles, whatever?
Yeah, I don't believe that there will be vehicles stored in it, but it'll be, I believe, a wood shop. Is that correct, Steve? Yeah.
Okay.
Hobby shop.
Hobby shop, so yeah. Like a shop. Okay. Thank you.
Anyone in the audience care to comment on this application? All right. Nobody else from the board has anything? Thank you for your presentation.
Thank you very much.
And we will call this hearing closed.
Very good.
Thanks, everybody, for coming. Start with a public hearing, we'll finish with a sketch. Okay, I assume that we're back on air. So why don't we start off with the first hearing, not the sketch, but the subdivision?
Yeah, we'll start with reviewing the subdivision application. And so the only thing that staff asked for during the PRC review was the drainage easement over Four Mile Creek area. That's been a typical procedure as we've been just like commissioned ditch for gaining access to those pieces as we go for future maintenance for regular ditch cleaning efforts that DPW does. It's usually on a 20 or 30 year cycle, but it's just access helps make everything easier. And it sounds like they're agreeing to that. We just will figure out.
That could be conditioned in the approval resolution.
That would be a part of it.
Yeah.
And has been included in the draft approval resolution that was provided prior to this meeting in the template. This is just a subdivision, so no site improvements, as I said.
There's no setbacks, there's no anything.
No, there's nothing. We're making a new lot line. They explain the future use, we'll see what happens in the future as that comes on, but it was nice that explained that. At this time, if the board's comfortable, we can have a vote to approve the Part 2 EAF, and then for the draft approval resolution.
I'll make a motion for the EAF, the Part 2.
Second.
All right, so we got the Nine Court and Bastion.
Second, sorry, gotta find it. Okay, Hetzke.
Aye.
Bastion?
Aye.
The Nine Court?
Aye.
Knauer?
Aye.
Tidings?
Aye.
Thank you. And for the draft approval resolution template?
I'll make a motion for that.
I'll second.
Hetzke?
Aye.
Bastion?
Aye.
Denoncourt?
Aye.
Knauer?
Aye.
Tidings?
Aye.
Thank you.
All right. Subdivision done.
Subdivision has been approved.
All right. How about the second item? Site plan.
looks like a pretty, this is the kind of property I'm jealous of.
Yeah,
I always wanted that nice long driveway and shop in the back. Oh my God.
One day, AJ, one day.
Yeah, pretty straightforward on this too. I
think I'm probably more ending up in Arbor Ridge or something.
So for this application, the applicants have provided responses to our PRC memo that was issued. They wanted to hold off on revising the plans until they had the public hearing. But the comments were in, and we're providing the drop this evening. County comments were environmental. We're aware of the environmental aspects out there for wetlands, floodplains, the drainage ditch. Obviously, again, we're still talking about that. They explained the driveway access, how that's going to work, how currently it diverts back to Green's property. That's all going to change, but everyone will have their access from the road. And we have been discussing with the fire marshal about whether or not the home has to be sprinklered or if a hydrant has to come in, and the applicant has expressed that they will comply with the fire code and work with the town fire marshal to make sure everything is what it needs to be.
The magic number is 600 feet off the mountain runway, correct?
From my conversations with the fire marshal, yes.
Is there 590?
Yep. Off the right of way. And
it's not 600.
Yep. So we'll work through the code, the New York State Fire Code, Building Codes, our code, and make sure everything is
falls within.
Yes, falls within regulations. Thank you.
You know, one thing I didn't ask and I should have was the driveway when they put it in, and we'll be able to support a fire truck then.
There should be a spec in the design.
Right.
Just stand
before that.
I would say whatever the fire code says.
So I just want to make that a point that they'll have to comply with that for their driveway.
Including, if needed, that existing gravel driveway to be brought up.
I said it would be paved, right?
To that same spec.
That's another item that I'll discuss with the fire marshal about bringing that.
Yeah, as long as they're cool.
Bringing that up to our town standards for fire access for emergency vehicles.
Just want to make sure we mention it.
Yep.
Yeah, it said this driveway is to be paved with a new right of way.
Okay. In the right of way, so yeah, we'll work through that in the pre-mylar process. Other than that, single family home, not within the E-pods.
Yeah, it's pretty straightforward.
Move to approve the Part 2 EAF.
1 second.
Bastion and Knauer.
Hetzke?
Aye.
Bastion?
Aye.
Denoncourt?
Aye.
Knauer?
Aye.
Tidings?
Aye.
Thank you. And the draft approval resolution for this was also provided.
Mm-hmm. Move to approve.
2nd.
All right, Hetzke?
Aye.
Bastion?
Aye.
Denoncourt?
Aye.
Knauer?
Aye.
Tidings?
Aye.
Thank you.
All right.
You guys have your approvals. We'll be in touch with the resolution and the follow-up steps.
Yay.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Thanks for coming in.
Come visit if you want, though.
All right. Yeah, I might. Can you pull that blue on the fridge?
Alright, and the last application, sketch plan for Penfield Storage. Excellent questions that we went through. PRC memo was out there. I provided a history of the resolutions that were issued in the 80s, how it got here. It is worth noting that
is he the owner or the manager?
I'm gonna go with manager right now. Our property management, county records, everything points to what was provided in the legal description for the two properties. So we have Lynn Perry Properties LLC and Raymond Pizzillo between the two properties. that owns. We could ask, yeah, and we can ask the question in the sketch letter about in the resubdivision process that they're planning to do to merge the two parcels, who would take ownership? Would these two remain, or would it be under new right. ownership?
Right. I personally don't. I think that building taking down the two buildings that are there right now, they're not exactly architectural masterpieces.
You described one as a block building.
Yeah. And so I don't really have an issue with that.
Okay. You described the lighting that was proposed?
Yeah, I think that it probably, even though it seems very close to the property line, I don't know if it ever would be seen from the south.
Not with
east. From the east.
Yeah, from the east side, from the apartments. They would have to get a zoning board variance for this, for the setbacks.
What about, I'm sure they'll leave room for green space as well.
Yes. Lot coverage, I assume they'll have to apply for variance for that as well, even with combining the two properties.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Their biggest problem is going to get rid of all those vehicles down there.
And
they couldn't even get a fire truck in if they wanted to.
Exactly.
I could barely get around with a car with the trailers parked there.
Yep, and that's what code enforcement visited the sites on last week or the week before, and he's since issued that letter to anyone who's using that space outside of
and they're operating
storage buildings.
Leased.
So yeah.
Two businesses out of that I'm aware of.
And he brought up a good point about fencing it in, trying to bring in some security, hopefully, to avoid this whole situation of I'm storing my stuff to take it in the morning. He's cleaning up the site, sounds like, and we can visit the site again between next Friday when he says it'll be done and the time when he comes back for a future application. Code enforcement would be checking on this regularly anyways to make sure that the notice that was issued has and the site's been brought back into compliance. Right now, our system would show it's an open notice that needs to be closed out, so they'll stay on top of that. Just go.
Okay.
Other things for the sketch letter, including bringing the site into compliance, specifying plans for ownership to the subdivision, detailing out the lighting, detailing specific parking, which he explained was anywhere from 8 to 10 spaces potentially, depending on how they want to deal with lot coverage. We discussed traffic, which is pretty low flow there.
Mm-hmm.
We can ask them to also provide any more details they have about security for the property if we want to look at that aspect of it, since it is a storage facility building. At least details about what the fencing is going to look like for the gate that they're proposing.
Yeah, yeah. How is it accessed? Is it a
keypad
or something? Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of times it's a code.
Yeah.
You get a code.
Yeah. My Uncle Bob's is like that.
Looks like the new building is going to be interior access only.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you're not going to have any garage doors opening and closing.
No, it would probably be something where you have a door on the outside and you access the center hallway.
Drive in or whatever.
Yeah, or probably drive in or walk in, depending on how they.
35 foot wide.
35 wide, so yeah.
You could drive in. I've seen those. The HVACs at the ground level could be noisy. Units, they generate noise. They have fans,
belts. Yeah, we'll let us see the detail because he said they'd be at the front of the building.
On each end.
It's a pretty commercial area.
You got the Penwood apartments there, but they're
pretty much it.
Right.
And you're going to have this 300-foot-long building, so you're going to have a 300-foot-long wall. I don't know how high the building's going to be. I'm not sure they
ask. Single story.
Okay. 20 feet?
Yeah.
15 feet?
I don't know.
They are preparing architecturals
and that'll come out when you do
that. And our three-sided view drawings.
It sounds like it's modeled after something in Buffalo.
Yeah, they've been there and done this before.
Yeah.
Right. So it's good to know they're working off an existing model, but all things we can include in the sketch letter to ask for those details when it comes time for a letter of intent and those any cut sheets they need to provide.
Anybody see any deal breakers in this?
It's tight, but I think it's an improvement overall.
Mm-hmm. I wasn't out there. To what extent is the buffer between the apartments?
You can see them. I mean, I think they're like arborvitaes or something. You can see, I mean.
Or yeah. Pines or something.
Pines, yeah.
Do you think that this building would create even a better buffer from the rest of the activity on the site?
I'm thinking.
From the PRC meeting?
Like paint trees on the...
yeah,
that's what...
Yeah.
No, because that back wall's almost going to be like a fence.
Well, we had a PRC meeting with Mr. Farrell as well, and he had talked to, I believe, Bob Morgan's group, who manages the apartments there. From that conversation, we don't have anything in writing right now, but we will ask for letters of support if there are any, the next application for this. He had described that how their conversation went was they were supportive of the building because it would offer an additional buffer and screening
from existing lights and
from
the
lights
sound
that
of
might
the
spill
light
over
sound,
and,
yeah.
And the sounds of the doors closings and whatnot. So it could enhance
it could be
the visual buffer
forest,
at least.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. But the landscaping is also worth asking about, detailing out what's remaining, what's getting pulled out for the existing features.
Right.
Yeah, if they end up leaving him, he said he was only going to remove two trees.
Yeah.
Now, you know, if they can do that, they'd be real lucky.
I don't have a problem.
One other item that might be worth including in the sketch letter is, since this application was before the planning board twice in the 80s, mid and late 80s. The late 80s, it came back for a similar building for storage inside because they claimed they needed it for to make the business more viable. However, the site was not in compliance with what the board originally approved at the time. So something worth noting to them now is asking, please state to us, describe how the site is now in compliance from its original approvals. Before we proceed.
That's why it was denied.
Correct. It was denied by the planning board and then by the zoning board because it required conditional use. So both boards had to deny it. So it's worth asking that to show compliance,
sure.
Not only with current things lying around, but also the site plan that was approved. Would we like to include anything about maintaining 360 fire access, possibly showing the temples
well,
of how?
I don't think we're going to get it around the longhouse.
At least explaining what their plan would be for fire access.
I don't even know if you're going to get it from that far corner.
Well,
I mean, the way it is right now, you can't. But
on the side to the fence, it's what, 10 feet in one corner?
Here, but that'd be all trees, right? Is that all a buffer?
But even if it was wide open, you're not going to get access to that. Is that okay with fire?
Right.
So that might be a showstopper.
Well, I'm just referring for access through the drive aisles.
Is it a block building?
Just the contents are going to burn. That's probably it.
We determined
request
30 feet.
Letter from the fire marshal addressing those concerns.
Yeah. You got to put a sprinkler system in.
I got common walls on my building with the properties next door. Fire trucks can't get all the way around my building.
Well, I think staff was really looking for just kind of around the entire site, not just the new building, because we have about 30 feet between the existing buildings and the proposed one on that aisle there. So it's something that, again, they should just be aware to plan for.
Well, yeah, I mean, plus, I mean, you look at this, it's 35 feet deep. What if it was, 290 by 100?
Yeah.
And they can get all the way around. What's the difference? I mean, if it was 100 feet wide, they'd have to go 50 feet across building to get to a fire in the middle, right? This,
yeah.
They got to go 35 feet from the front to the back.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So, it's something.
Say that. I mean, we obviously want the fire marshals.
The fire marshal will weigh in when the plans come in, obviously.
Sit at home,
saying, let it burn. So with that, we can take all those comments, put it in a sketch letter, send it out. Just need a motion from the board to issue a sketch letter.
I'll make a motion to issue a sketch letter.
Moved by Bastian, seconded by?
Second.
Thank you.
Nice quick turn there, Roseanne.
Hetzke?
Aye.
Sebastian?
Aye.
Denoncourt?
Aye.
Denauer?
Aye.
Tidings?
Aye.
Thank you very much.
All right.
With that, we have no follow-up items. We have two approvals that will be sent out to the applicants. And we're moving to our pre-mylar process for the Marchner Road projects.
Great. All set. Thank you, everyone.
You're not here next month, right?
Set?
You're not here next month.
Correct.
We're not here. Anyone else with a conflict in August?
Last time I worked, they were going to be here.
All right.
You here? You're here.
I'll be on vacation again.
Spend your whole life on vacation. You're here.
I got to catch up on the.
I believe I checked before when you asked.
Well, this enforcement in the town.
Sounds good. You can wrap it up.
All right. We will adjourn this meeting. Thank you.